Hello students, welcome to the second session of science. So in the last class we saw about the plants and different parts of it. In this session you will be learning about the food which is very very essential for life and about where they come from, what are the sources, where do we get all these things. About those things only today we are going to see. So food, you know what is food from the from your baby, you know what is food. Without food we cannot live. So we eat food for being healthy, we eat food for getting energy, we eat food for taste. There are many many different kinds of food that we eat. In each family it varies. In some family they may be vegetarian, in some family they may be non-vegetarian, in some family they may take both of it, some they have only eggs. So it differs from each home. So today we are going to see all these varieties and where does it come from. So what did you have at home today? What did you eat at home today? Then find out what your friend had today. Did you have the same meal as yesterday, the same food what you ate yesterday? No, it varies from day to day. We eat different types of food every day. So there are many many varieties and kinds of food, right? So about those varieties and the ingredients, what are the ingredients used in it, are the things that we are going to see now. So now we are going to see about the food and where does it come from. So in that we are going to first see about the food variety. So what are the types of varieties are there? So example, you take, you have rice, you have different type of curries, vegetable curry, chicken curry. So there are many many types of dishes. So in food there are many different varieties. So different varieties of food are there. So for example, if you take rice, so to cook a rice, what are the ingredients needed? We need water and rice. So two ingredients, only two ingredients we need to cook a rice. Whereas if you see vegetable curry, we need vegetables, salt, spice and oil, etc. We need many materials to cook the vegetable curry. So in each recipe the number of ingredients changes. So there are many different varieties of food. And next we are going to see about the food materials. What are the food materials, that is the ingredients and their sources. What are the sources of different food? Sources means where does it comes from. So rice, if you take, means it is coming from the plants. If you take egg, does it come from a plant? No, it comes from the hens, that is an animal. So milk also we get from the cow, that is also an animal. So now we are going to see the different sources and the food materials. First, fruits and vegetables comes from plants. So all types of food, fruits that you eat and vegetables that you eat are all come from the plants only. For rice and wheat, like I already said, for rice and wheat, they are cultivated from the fields of rows of rice and wheat plant. So in rice and wheat, you would have seen the fields. In a row, they would plant all the wheat and rice plants and they will cultivate, all the farmers will cultivate the plants and then only we get rice and wheat. So this is one source of the rice and wheat. Next, food like milk, egg, meat comes from animals. So food like the milk, egg and meat also comes from animals only. So here we saw about plants and now we are seeing about animals. Milk, egg and meat comes from animals. And plants are sources of food ingredients like grains, cereals, vegetables and fruits. So from plants we not only get the rice and wheat, we also get cereals, all the grains that we eat, the moong dal, all the dal types. So everything comes from the plants.
plants only. So that is what is said here. And finally, animals provide milk and meat products and eggs. So animals will provide milk products. All the milk products means what we can tell? We can tell butter, cheese, ghee. So all these things are milk products only. So from animals we get all these things and the milk products and eggs also. And finally, what are the animals that gives milk? Cows, goats, buffaloes are the common animals that give milk. So cow, goats and buffaloes are the common animals that will give milk. Now I am going to give you a short recap from the first we saw what are the different varieties of food. There are many types of food. In each variety the ingredients differ. Some may have two ingredients alone. For rice and for vegetables we may have different number of ingredients. For vegetable curry we need many ingredients, whereas if you see rice means only two ingredients. And different food materials and their what energy sources, from where does it come from. We saw about fruits and vegetables, they come from plants, and how they are cultivated. Wheat and rice are cultivated in fields. Then we saw the milk, egg and meat is obtained from animals. And we saw cereals, grains and all, it is obtained from the plants. And we saw about all the milk products and animal products that come from milk, and cows and goats will give milk. Now we are going to see the different parts of plants and their sources. So what I told you, we get food from the plants and animals. So plants means we should see what are the parts present and what are the parts that we are using as food. So for that only I have drew the diagram of the plant parts, and we will see on food basis how they are useful. So first you can find the stem is there, the leaf is present, your bud is there, the fruits are there and a flower is there. So together they are called as shoot system. And finally in root, primary root and second root. The main root is the primary root, and at last the small other outgrowths are the secondary root. So these are all, the whole plant is edible only. So each plant differs. In some plants we eat the leaf, in some plants we eat all the fruits, in some plants we may eat the flowers also. So it varies from different plants. So these are the parts of plants and they are the edible parts. And now we are going to see the theory part. We eat many leafy vegetables. So what we do, we eat many leafy vegetables. So leafy vegetables means you can say greens, all the spinaches and cabbage is also a leafy vegetable only. So we eat all the leaves. So that is also edible. And next, roots, stems and flowers are also sometimes edible. The root means a potato also is a root only. It is an underground root. It is a modified root. It has been changed into a vegetable. So that is also a root only. We are eating roots. Stem means all the banana stem and all we will be eating. We will be consuming it as food. And flowers also, it is edible. Sometimes it is edible. We eat the flowers also. And some plants have two or more edible parts. So some plants, not only one part. If you take greens means only leaf is the edible part. If you come, but there are some plants, both more than two parts are being edible. We can eat the other parts. So banana stem you can take. You can eat the stem also, and we eat the root also. So that is also an example. So more than two parts are being edible, are being taken by us as food. And seeds of mustard plants gives us oil, and leaves are used as vegetables. So if you take the mustard plant, what happens? The seeds are taken and we take mustard oil. So that is one food material. And in the same mustard plant, we take the leaves and it is being consumed as food. So from one single plant itself, two types of edible parts are there. So this is an example. Next, a small white structure may have grown white structures, what happens is you take any cell or something like that, and what you do, you wrap it in a wet cloth and keep it overnight. So in the morning you can see small small white outgrowths in all the cells. So those are known as these sprout seeds have sprouted. So the white outgrowths are known as sprouts. It can be eaten as raw, and we can mix the spices and eat it. We can also cook it. So these are called sprouts. The white outgrowth from the seed is called as sprout, and those seeds are called as sprouted. So these are the sources of different parts of the plant, and that is used as food. And bees collect nectar. Next, we are moving on to the animals. Bees collect nectar. That is a sweet juice. What bees do? They go to different flowers and they collect the nectar. That is the sweet juice. And what they do? They convert it into honey and store it in their beehive. So you would have seen the beehives or not. So what bees does is it goes to the flower. It takes the sweet juice. That is the nectar. From the flower, they suck all the sweet juice and they come to the beehive. And what they do, they will convert that nectar into honey and store it in the hive. That is the beehive. And next, what happens? Flowers and their nectar may be available only for a part of it. So if that sweet juice, I told you, it is taken from the bees. If that nectar remains in the plant, in the flower itself, what happens? It will be there for only a part of year, maybe a few months. But if you see in bees, what they do, if they store their nectar in their hive, it will be for many years. It won't be spoiled. It will be there for many years. But if that nectar is remaining in the flower itself, what happens? The nectar will disappear, it will get degenerated. But in the bees, if you see, means will be there for throughout the year. So from beehive only we get honey. So you would have seen people taking honey from the beehive. So from this beehive only we are getting honey. So this is an animal product. We are getting a source of food from the animal. So these are, so we also the sources of food from plants and from animals also. Now I will give you a short recap from the first. First we saw the different edible parts that we are eating as food: the flower, fruit, bud, leaves, stem, the roots we saw. So these are the edible parts that we consume as food. Then we saw about leafy vegetables, and we also consume roots, stem and flowers. In one plant itself, there might be two edible parts. So for example, you are taking mustard, oil is also taken, those leaves are also used as food. And we saw about sprouted seeds, so how to make a sprouted seed. And then we saw the animal products, about honey we saw. We get from the nectar, from the flower, the nectar is collected by the bees and it is stored in the hive by the bees. If it remains in the flower, it will disappear. But if you see in the bees, it will be there for throughout all the year. And from the beehive only, we will get honey. Now, we are going to see about the various sources of food and what are the food and its sources. So, types of food sources are the plant sources and the animal sources. The foods that are obtained from the plants are known as plant sources, and foods that are obtained from animals are known as animal sources. So first we are taking the plant sources. Now we are going to see about the plant sources and what are the food products. So the source is the plant. From plant we take each part of the plant and it is used as an edible. We take them as food. We eat the roots as a source of food. We eat all the flowers also, some of the flowers also as source of food. And fruit also is consumed. Even leaves are also consumed. So the first example for leaf vegetable is cabbage. So cabbage, if you see, means it is a leafy vegetable. So we use them to as food, and it is a leaf from a plant. Next is, the next source of food is carrot. So carrot, it is a modified root. Actually, it is a root. It has been modified into a vegetable. So carrot is also been taken as food, and it is edible. So this is one example of plant sources. The next is the sunflower. So sunflower is a flower, as we know. So what we can do with sunflower? We take all these seeds, and oil is being taken, and we use them as edible food. So this is also one example for flower being the edible part. The next food source is animal source. So what are the animals involved for our consumption of food that we are going to see now? First is the cow. So with cow, what can we do? We get all the milk products. So milk products means it includes milk, cheese, butter, ghee, and everything. So sometimes it is also consumed for meat purposes also. So it is consumed as meat, and it also gives milk, and from that we can obtain different milk products. The next food source is goat. So from goat, what do we get? Like cow itself, we get meat, and it also gives milk and other milk products also. Whereas if you see in fish, it gives meat alone. The meat of the fish is taken as food. So these are the animal sources. Now we are going to see the food sources. In that, first is plant sources. So plants, if you see, means we get different vegetables and fruits. First we are going to see the different types of fruit. So banana is one fruit that is obtained from the plant. It is a plant source. Next, mango. So mango is also obtained from the plant source only. From the mango tree we get mango. So that is a food product which is obtained from plant sources. Next is orange. So orange is also another plant source that we obtain, and it is edible. So the next is grapes. Grapes is also a plant source. From the climbers we get grapes. And finally, apple is also from the plant sources. We get them from the trees.
Now I am going to explain about sprouts and how to prepare them. So now I am going to tell the preparation. Now take some dry seeds of moong dal or chana dal. You can take a small quantity of seeds in a container with water and leave it for a day. The next day, what you do, drain all the water completely and leave those seeds in the vessel and wrap them with wet cloth and keep it aside. Next day, if you see, means you can see some changes in the seeds. So like you can see in the image, you can see small sprouts coming out, some white outgrowths in the seeds. So those are only called as sprouts, and they are called as sprouted. And after washing these sprouted seeds, you can eat them just like that, or you can also cook them. Use some spices like salt, sugar, or you can also use chili powder and eat it. It can be eaten as a tasty snack. So these sprouts are very nutritious. So comparing to the dried seeds, these sprouts are very, very nutritious. In some of your houses and all, you would have eating every day or most of the time. So it is very nutritious than the normal dried seeds.
We saw about the food and the source of food. From where do we get the food? And their parts, the different parts of plants that are used for eating and everything we saw. We have discussed about the food that we are consuming, that human beings are consuming. What are the food types of varieties of food that we eat, and what are the ingredients that are used for making the food? So all those things we saw. Now we are going to see about animals. What do animals eat? So for example, you may have pet animals at your home, or the animals, wild animals, and all the domestic animals, all the roadside animals. So what are the types of food that they intake? So dog, if you are having a dog, then you know what are the types of food that you give. So some may give pedigree and some may give rice also. So the cats may eat fish and all the chicken, meat products, you know, they eat. So about all these things we are going to see now. So based on the eating habits, animals are divided into herbivore, carnivore, and omnivore. Herbivore, carnivore, and omnivore. So based on how they eat, based on their eating habits, they have been classified into three types. They are herbivore, carnivore, and omnivore. So these are the three types of animals that has been classified according to their eating habits. So let us see one by one in detail now. First is herbivore. So herbivore means herb, that means it denotes some plants. So you would have heard the term herbs. So herbs means all the plants, and all the tulasi, the coriander, and all, they are all herbs only. So herbivore means it denotes the plants. So animals that eat only plants and their plant products. So plant products means it may be the seeds, it may be the flower, it may be the fruit. All these are the plant products, the products that are obtained from the plants. So those plants and plant products, the set of animals, herbivore animals, only eat plants and their products. So such animals are called as herbivore. So example for herbivore, goat. So goat, if you say, means they do not eat anything apart from plants. Only plants they eat. They eat all the grass, they eat the leaves. Other than that, they don't eat anything. Next, sheep also, it is the same case. It eats only all the leaves and grasses. Deer also, it is like that only. So all these three animals are coming under herbivore. Why? All these animals eat only plant and plant products. Next is carnivore. So carnivore, carni means it denotes animals, flesh eating. So animals that eat other animals, so the animal that eats the flesh of the another animal and survive and eat their food and survive, so that the other animals are only their food. So such animals are called as carnivore. So example, lion. So lion, tiger, leopard, and all, if you see, means they will go catch other animals, for example deer, goat, and anything it can be. What they do, they just hunt for their prey and they take the animal and they eat their raw meat, raw flesh, like that itself. So such animals, such flesh eating animals, those animals which eat other animals are known as carnivore. Animals that eat other animals are called carnivore. Example, lion, tiger, and leopard. Lion, tiger, and leopard. So these are the things under carnivore. Next is omnivore. Omni omnivore. So omnivore means they eat both the plants and the animals. Such type of animals are called as omnivore. So they eat the plants also, the plant products also, and they eat small insects, the birds, also anything it can be. So eating both anything, if they get anything, they will eat. Only thing, if it does not eat only plant or it does not eat only animals, it eats both. It is a mixture of herbivore and carnivore. So those animals are only called as omnivore. So animals that eat both plants and animals. Animals that eat both plants and animals. So those animals are known as omnivores. So example, dog, bear and monkey. So dogs, now if you see, they eat the vegetables also. And sometimes they eat the rats and other small insects also. So bear also, it is the same case. It eats the honey also, and it also eats the fish also. It is an omnivore. So monkeys also, it is the same case. So they both eat both plants and animals. So these are the three types of animals based on their eating habits. So now I will give you a short recap from the first. What do animals eat? That was the topic we were saying now. So based on the eating habits, they are divided into herbivore, carnivore, omnivore. So these are the three types of animals that has been classified based on their eating habits. Herbivore means animals that eat only plant and plant products are known as herbivore. Example, goat, sheep and deer. These are the examples of herbivore. Next, carnivore means animals that eat other animals are known as carnivore. Example, lion, tiger and leopard. So these are the examples for carnivore. Next is omnivore. So animal that eat both plants and animal. Animal that eat both plants and animal are known as omnivore. Example, dog, bear and monkey. Dog, bear and monkey. So these are the examples of omnivore. Next is in the lesson, from the starting till the ending of the lesson, we saw about different types of food, the source of food, how do we get, whether it is from plants or animals, and how do we get, what type of part we get from the plants and from animals, means how do we get that animal product and all. Then we saw the classification of animals that are based on their eating activities. So this is all about food. So there are many people around us and many organisms around us. They are in need of food. Everyone needs food. We also need food every day. We have sufficient source, so we eat and we live daily. But some people, in case of others, there are a set of people who does not have any food to eat, and they are working hard to get a meal per day. That itself it is very difficult. So you children have to think about all those needy people, how they are suffering from getting food and all. You have to think, and you should find ways to easily make the food to reach the people. They should easily get the food to eat. So it is a change should be made now itself in your mind. In the future, you may find some ways to help the needy. You may find some ways to make food get easily by the people. So that is what the last conclusion of the lesson. Many among us are there and they are in need of food. So there are some easy ways to be made to get food. So I hope you learn something in the lesson. Just go through the lesson, and if you have any doubts, note down and do your activities correctly. Thank you, children.
This is an activity for you. Ask your friends about the items that they would eat during a day and see if you can also get the information from friends who are staying in different states of India. What are the types of food they eat, and list out in this table. Write the name of the student or friend and write the food that they eat every day. This is your second activity. So in the first activity, you wrote what are the food that is eaten by your friends and your classmates. Now you are going to ask your parents or elders how they are made. For example, if you see the chapati is made using atta and water. So dal means pulses, water, salt or ghee, oil or ghee, and spices are used for preparation. So like this, the food that you have mentioned in table 1, take any food and write its ingredients. What are the ingredients used for preparation in the given tabular column? This is your third activity. So in the last tabular column, we wrote about the food and different ingredients. In this tabular column, you are going to write the source. Where are these ingredients obtained from? Whether it is from a plant or whether it is from an animals, the source, where do we get the ingredient? That alone you are going to write in this table. So there are some missing blanks in the sources column. So for example, we will take the first thing. First is the idli. About the food item is idli. Under idli, what are the ingredients used? Rice, urad dal, salt and water are used. So rice, I already told you, rice is a plant source. From plant only we are taking the rice. So urad dal, where does it come from? You have to think, ask your parents and write it down. Like this, you have to write for salt, water and spices. So all the blanks that are left in the sources column, fill those column and submit it. This is your fourth activity. Here you have to write the name of the food item and all the ingredients that are used and what is the part of the plant that is used to obtain the plant part that is used as a source. For example, we are taking brinjal curry. So in that, the ingredients are brinjal and chili powder, oil from groundnut, mustard, soya bean and any other plant. So these are the ingredients or sources and the plant part. So for brinjal is a fruit, so it is a modified fruit, so we are writing is as a fruit. So the spice, red chili is also a fruit only, that is also a modified fruit, so they are writing as a fruit. And oil from groundnut, so groundnut, mustard, all these things are seeds. So under the plant part, they are writing it as seed. So likewise, you also write any two food items and list out the ingredients and what are the plant part that gives the ingredient. Write this tableau column and fill it.